Google Bard have just added extensions. So a bit like ChatGPT extensions, Google Bard have now added their own extensions to other Google products. And I tell you what, it's a game changer, because now you've basically got an AI for your own information. And I think this is a really, really cool integration of existing Google apps with Google Bard. And I'm going to take you through it. So if you go to Google Bard here, you'll see up here, you've got extensions, okay? And you can turn these on. So Bard extensions help you bring it all together. Go from tons of tabs to one conversation. So you don't have to have your email open or your Google Docs or anything like that. If you tick these boxes, Google Bard will search your Google Docs, your own personal Google Docs, for information that you're looking for. And then you can utilize the power of Google search the internet to sort of bring things together. So Bard extensions help you bring it all together. Go from tons of tabs to one conversation. Bard can now access info from new sources, starting with maps, YouTube, flights, hotels, and Google Workspace, which of course includes Gmail, Drive, Docs, etc. And you can locate information, you can sum up a doc, break it down for me, all of that. And I think it's really, really cool, and I'm going to show you how it works. So we're going to start here. I'm going to say, check the recent trips on my at Google Maps. If you just put in at, it comes up with the different various Google apps that you can use. Now, I've done this before, and I didn't have to tell it Google Maps, but Google Bard's playing up at the moment, so we'll see whether this works, because this is extraordinary when it does work. Okay, I cannot provide the exact route you took. At least it's honest. The exact distance of the route is 4 hours, 1 minute to complete by car. Okay, I get that. That's fine. How much was my recent Premier Inn bill? Okay. I stayed in a hotel. I want to know how my recent, how much my recent Premier Inn bill was. Okay. So here's the stay. Your book's been confirmed. Okay, so we'll go. And there it goes. Your booking dates for your Premier Inn stay were the 15th to 16th of September. And then it's got kind of invoice and all of that. It's got some other stuff. It's just search. All my booking emails if I want to click on that. Okay. What other hotels are nearby? Presuming it still understands the context of nearby that particular hotel. Okay, now it hasn't. So let's just be, I was asking for hotels near the hotel I recently stayed at, checking my emails for the hotels I stayed at. And there we go. Hotels near the Premier Inn Truro, which is where I stayed. But this weekend, and it's saying the Cornish Bank, Country Arms Truro, Summer Valley Touring Park, Donington Guesthouse, Ship and Castle Hotel. Again, based on these emails. So it's found the hotels near the hotel I stayed at based on my hotels. So it's using a combination of searching for my emails and then searching on the web using Google Hotels to find suitable hotels. So really, really cool. Okay, find my document about Stadia 2.0. So I did a video recently and I wrote a script for it, and say I can't find it, whatever. So this is going to go here, and there's that playable script. Okay, so now we go, I can either just call up the script, or how about we go summarize the playables script in list above, okay? So there we go, it's summarized that document that I was looking for, okay? So how about post an email outlining this summary, okay? This is going to ask it to compose an email. So here we go. Hi team. It's created an email instantly, really quick as well. That was real time. Again, some random emails it finds. Items used for this last response. Just random emails that I get from people here. Hi team, I'm writing to summarize the playable script document. Playable script discusses the potential of Google's new playables feature, which allow users to play casual games on YouTube without downloading. Overall, the playable script is a thoughtful analysis of potential of Google's new playables feature. Script acknowledges the challenges that Playable faces, but it also argues that Playables has the potential to be a successful successor to Google Stadia. Let me know. So if I wanted to send an email about that document without even opening the document, it's found the document, it's summarized the document, and there you go. I could just send that out. I mean, really, really cool. As I said, if you press just the at in there, you've got, you know, YouTube maps. Why don't we go YouTube's recent YouTube video on Stadia 2.0. See if you can find that. This is on my main channel, not the AI channel I've got. See if it's going to find it or whether it's just doing a general search. Just found it. Okay, so why don't we be more precise? On my YouTube channel, to see if it knows who I am. Brilliant. Okay. My three most recent videos on my main YouTube channel. Let's go at Clive Illinden. See if it that, right? See if that confuses it. Or see if it understands if I put at Clive Illinden. I'm going to find the YouTube channel, the right YouTube channel. It's searching YouTube. There we go. Brilliant. It's found the last. Well, these aren't the last three, but they're far from the last three. That's interesting. Some of these are months old. Here are the three most recent videos on your YouTube channel. That's very, very interesting. Why is that? Okay. Summarize the first video in this list. See if that works. A YouTube video. Sorry, it can't summarize videos yet. Well, there are some apps that can do that. So it'd be good if you could start integrating other apps that would allow you to do that. So that's a bit of a disappointment. But as you can see, I mean, I think there's real potential here. It's still not quite as intuitive or accurate as I'd like it to be. When I first tested it, it felt it worked kind of much more seamlessly. Of course, I come to record it, and I think there's some errors in where it came back. But the potential to be able to search documents, search your Gmails, you know, compose Gmails, interact with the web, bring it all together, is just really, really cool. There we are. I hope you found that useful. I mean, just to summarize here, you've got Google Flights, Google Hotels, over here, Google Maps, Google Workspace, which obviously Gmail, Drive and Docs. And but here you've got like YouTube and help solve a problem, get inspired, research a topic, all of that. I just think it's really cool that you can do research, say, you know, looking for your own documents, whether they are in Gmail, whether they're a doc, look at recent journeys, then interact with the internet as a whole and kind of compile and put stuff together. So really, really cool. And you can turn the extensions off anytime. One conversation, many extensions, as it says. Anyway, I hope you found that useful. I hope you found it interesting. It's not perfect, but I think there's real potential here. And I'm going to certainly be using it because I have my docs all over the place, or I'm looking for Gmails. And it's just great to be able to say, find me this, fetch me that, bring it all together, and then create something new from it. So really, really cool. As I said, if you like this video, please hit the likes because I like it. YouTube likes it. And it helps people like you find content like this. And if you're new to my channel, then do me the great favor, why don't you hit that subscribe button, toggle that notification bell, and that way you'll know when I go live with content just like this. Talking of content just like this, why don't you check out the videos right here? These ones here. You'll like them.